JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's Daily Market Review for August the 24th. I am Charalambos Pissouros, Head of Research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded lower against all the other major currencies on Monday and during the Asian session on Tuesday. It fell the most against the commodity-linked CAD and ZD and AUD in that order, while it slid the least versus JPY and the euro. The weakening of the US dollar and the Japanese yen combined with the strengthening of the risk-linked Aussie kiwi and loonie suggests that financial markets traded in a risk-on fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that European shares traded in positive territory, with appetite improving even further during the US and Asian sessions. Both the S&P 500 and Nasdaq hit fresh record highs. Initially, EU shares recovered from their biggest weekly loss in nearly 6 months, helped by mining and oil stocks as commodity prices bounced back, with appetite improving more later in the day and today in Asia as the US Food and Drug Administration, the FDA, granted full approval to the coronavirus vaccine developed by Pfizer and BioNTech. This could cut down hesitancy and accelerate the vaccination process, at least in the US. What's more, full approval means that the vaccine could get mandatory in some sectors, industries and firms. The Pentagon has already said that it is preparing to obligate military personnel to get the jab, while New York said that it will require all public school teachers to take it. Having said all that, though, we don't expect the same euphoria today as market participants may slowly start adopting a more cautious approach ahead of the Jackson Hole Economic Symposium scheduled to begin on Thursday. All the attention is likely to fall on speeches by Fed officials and especially Fed Chief Jerome Powell, who will step up to the rostrum on Friday. At the latest policy gathering, Powell appeared dovish, but the minutes of that meeting revealed that officials largely supported beginning the normalization process later this year. What's more, in the aftermath of the meeting, most of them expressed a more hawkish view than Powell, which combined with strong employment and inflation data, increased speculation that the Fed could start scaling back its quantitative easing purchases in the months to come, perhaps as early as next month. So, it will be interesting to see whether Powell has changed his mind to support an earlier withdrawal. Up until the end of last week, there was decent speculation that he will provide relatively clear signals over the Fed's future course of action. However, on Friday, Dallas Fed President Robert Kaplan said he might reconsider his hawkish stance if the virus hurts the economy, while yesterday data showed that business activity in the US slowed for a third straight month due to the virus spreading. This may have lessened the confidence that Powell will provide a clear quantitative easing tapering roadmap. Therefore, with the outcome very uncertain, we believe that investors are unlikely to alter much their portfolio balances ahead of the event. We believe that equities, especially in the EU and the US, may continue trading north, but at a slower pace, while the US dollar may stay on the defensive for a while more. For the greenback to resume its recent uptrend, we believe that fresh signals over early tapering may be needed. This could also hurt equities at the moment, but we don't expect trend reversal. As we noted several times recently, stock indices seem to have stayed in their upside trajectories, whatever market participants anticipate around the Fed. In the past, before last week, we saw Wall Street hitting records at times when normalization expectations were brought forth, perhaps as investors were rushing to take advantage of low interest rates for as long as possible. But we also saw equities drifting north when such expectations were pushed back. This may have been due to the fact that low interest rates for longer mean low borrowing costs for companies for longer, as well as lower present values for longer. Now, as for today's events, the calendar appears relatively light today, with the only releases worth mentioning being Germany's final GDP for the second quarter, which is expected to confirm its preliminary estimate, and the US new home sales for July, which are expected to have increased somewhat. Tonight, during the Asian morning Wednesday, New Zealand's trade balance for July is coming out, but no forecast is available. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.